Let me fill my pouch with these later. From a camp. Maybe I should check it out. That might be the Alcerin camp this mob told me about. I should talk to their leader.
Now she's in the wilds, all alone. Forge knows all the things that could kill her out there.
Someone ran off?
Never got her name. Kept quiet. Couldn't tell if she was shy or scared. All I know is she didn't want anyone near her things.
That's for sure. I was just curious, is all. She didn't have to slug me.
Your glass jaw ain't the problem, Lugnut. The girl is. All alone in the bush? And this is Tanakh territory.
Which way did she go?
West, up the slope. Look for her if you can.
I will.
Careful now. The girl's maladjusted.
Looks like we have company.
Must be closing in on the signal.
Rest for a moment, friend.
I'll never believe it all back
home. You might want to avoid going too deep into the desert, especially the southwest. One of our scouts ran into some nasty Tanakh down there, the kind that contain machines. He barely made it back alive.
Thanks for letting me know. Sounds like the rebels are as friendly as ever. I wonder what they're doing this for. Are you lost?
Spark to steal. Aren't you a jewel in a junk heap?
Excuse me?
Hold the hammer? I know you. You're that Nora. The savior. My savior. Right in the nick of time. The name's Poor Guff Delvesman, chief delver and leader of Poor Guff's expeditioners and purveyors of fine delvewares.
What am I saving you from, exactly?
Death and despair, my steel flame friend. See, this grand expedition here has had a minor setback. Not far from here, there's a secret tunnel, a passage of the old ones, lost and then found. Me and half the crew came through first. The other half was supposed to follow right after. But days later, only one man turned up, shivering like a frog in chill water. Only thing we got out of him was that death and darkness chased them as the tunnel collapsed. Died with his eyes wide, he did.
I've been to the tunnel's eastern side. The way was blocked by rubble. There was also a body, one of your delvers, I guess, but no sign of the rest of the crew.
Keep your voice down, will you? The rest of the crew's already spooked. They're refusing to press on with the delve until they're assured a way out of here.
You lost half your crew and you're worried about the delve.
We gotta make their sacrifice worth something, right? And besides, now that you're here, maybe our sand-stranded days are over. Help me get that tunnel reopened and I'll cut you in on the delver's fee. What do you say?
I'll see what I can do about the tunnel.
My savior.
For the crew trapped here with you, not your delve.
One and the same.
That it, over there?
That it is. Oh, and while you're at it, would you mind keeping an eye out for my lockbox? The second crew was supposed to bring the rest of the supplies and belongings. I'd hate to lose it to the wilds. It was hand-carved by my dear old Ma.
I'll bring it back, if I find it.
I'd appreciate it. Good luck, Steel Flame.
You can ride machines, right? Apparently, you're not the only one. But you probably knew that.
Dudes might look peaceful, but they hide all kinds of things.
Talana, glad to see you made it.
Thanks to the secret passage through your base. It was quite a sight. Secret passage? Don't let the others hear you say that, or you'll have a lot of Oseram knocking at your door.
And you are?
This is Raggard. He's a scout with this caravan. He says Amadis was here.
He joined up with our expedition right before we went through the tunnel. After we made camp here, I set out to do some scouting. I also made peace offerings to the Tanakh for trespassing in their territory. Amadis wanted me to ask around about some place called the Rot.
What did you find out?
Most I learned was that it's where the Tanakh took their prisoners. Somewhere far to the west near Thorn Marsh, the Lowland Clan's capital. He set out to find it not long after.
On his own?
I tried to warn him, but he was dead set on going.
Thanks, Robert. This has been helpful.
Hope you find him.
Okay, I'll head for Thornmarsh. Meet me there.
Hold on.
What?
You're willing to go to the ends of Tanakh's territory to find this guy. No hesitation.
Of course, he's one man alone in the Forbidden West. I'm just worried about him.
I think it's more than that. I'll meet you near the Lowland capital. But then, you're going to tell me who Amadis really is.
Fine. I'll lay low, north of the village. See you there.
If I have to eat
Tanakh rebels hold up in an outpost
time.
Nearby need a beating, Huntress. Oh, hi! Thank you.
pouch is full, but my pack has room.
Machine saw me.
Looks like an awesome camp. But where is everyone? My focus might show me more. The last room I met said someone in their crew ran off in this direction. I should keep my eyes open.
Stay back!
Sounds like someone's in trouble. She's gonna need some backup.
Is it safe? Did they get to it? Please be intact. Please.
I should make sure she's okay. The spike is still intact. Rig's still playing. You okay there? You took out those machines. I'm grateful, but you should go now. There's nothing to see here.
So this rig of yours, it's receiving sound through that wire from the thing up on the cliff, what you call a spike. But the message is only a fragment, and you're trying to pick up the whole thing?
How did you figure all that out?
I've learned a few things in my travels. If you want, we could talk about it. Maybe I can help.
You do seem downright knowledgeable. So go ahead. Shoot.
How did you first hear the message?
I used to be a smith up in the claim. Wasn't an easy life. A lot of hard work without much to show for it. Then, one day, I heard a whisper coming from a steel rod. Faint, like the last fingers of steam coming off a cooling forge. When I moved the rod around, the whispers got louder. I did some tinkering, built my rig, and did my best to follow that sound. Further west I came, the stronger it got. Then I found that spike up there. When I hooked up my rig, the words were clearer than ever.
What do you think the message is?
I don't know. There's something sad about it. Feels like it's from one lost soul to another. I'd sure like to know what it means.
Let me have a look at that spike. I might be able to pick up more of that message.
How?
Let's just say I have a rig of my own.
I didn't know Nora were tinkers.
They're not, but I am, in a way. Be right back.
Well, okay then. I guess. Just follow the wire to the spike at the top. And please, just don't break anything.
Better get climbing. Credit lugging all that wire up a cliff wall. There's a spike. Might get better reception if I'm next to it. Interesting. Can't seem to get a fix on where the signal's coming from, though. Well, better let the Tinker know I got a bit more of the message. I'm cooking my armor in this heat. This ought to be a good shortcut. Your rig is picking up an old-world message. A recording of some kind.
Thought as much. Did you hear more of it?
A bit. It was recorded during a war. A bad one. Maybe that's why it sounds so darn sad. There's something about it that makes me think of my late brother. May his ashes stay warm in the forge. Not sure why, exactly. I still can't get a fix on the source. Well, the words grew stronger when I got out here.
What if you moved the rig now? Try to see if you can get a stronger signal elsewhere.
Even if I could dodge the Tanakh and the machines, I can't lose that spike. Nothing else pulls down the words better.
Okay. If it's an old world message, then let's try old world methods. They used to pinpoint signals by listening for them at three different spots. The taller, the better. And then they combined the information and used it to find the source.
And you can do that?
I think so. But your spike is only one spot. I need two more, both up high.
Oh. Well, there's a big bright tower in the Tanakh territory north of here.
Yeah, that should work. I have another spot in mind, near a place I'm... camping.
Wait. I don't know your name. Or why you do all of this for someone you just met.
Aloy. And because I want to know what's out there. Same as you.
Selga. And when you find it, Aloy, I'd be eager to hear what it is.
I see you, champion. Sit, please.
This mountain. The southern face is my best bet for a climb if I want to get more of Silka's message. Just gotta look for a... path. Now that I'm here, I should try climbing up the mountain to get more of Silga's message. The southern face should get me to a good spot. Sneak past.
My focus is jammed.
A good spot to pick up Silga's signal. This is quite a climb. Plasma's wasted against that machine. I have to get higher to try and pinpoint Silga's signal. Thank you. This mountain is tall. Looks like I have company. Spotted. Okay, better. Okay, now to pick up the signal. Where's the best spot? I should try to find a good spot to pick up Silva's message. Signal's getting stronger. My focus almost has where it's coming from. Time to pay that Tanakh tower a visit. Bet I'll get a nice... Finally stopping. Should help me pinpoint Silva's signal.
Welcome. You and ally just for today.
You wanted to speak to me?
The name's Zoka. Have you heard from up north? From Bleeding Mark?
I'm guessing that's a place.
One of the desert's villages. They send their yield of ash blood so the Bereka over there can mark the skin of our soldiers. But it's been a long time since the last supply run. Too long.
If you think something happened to them, can't you send someone to go check?
Were it up to me, but the capital's already dealing with machines, storms, and strict water rations. No one can be spared.
If I'm out that way, I can look in on the village, find out what's the delay.
You have my thanks. Head north to a ruin where the desert meets the mountains. That's Bleeding Mark. Ask for Kentok or Natika there. They'll know what's going on.
Thank you.
Move, soldier, move!
I'm up to look for Silga's signal, but where to start?
earned our trust.
Oh, don't mind me. Just doing a little climb. Keep climbing to pinpoint that signal. A little higher. Almost there. Okay, let's see if I can pick up Silga's signal. Origin. It's not too far from here. I just need to get to it.